Welcome back from the break. We're glad you're watching. Now remember, you can be a part of the show by getting to our social media pages right below your screen. Drop us a comment and tell us what you think about the show. Plus, if you feel there are any topics that you need addressed on the program, we'll be certainly sure to look for the sources to explain to you what you need to know to better your business. Remember, the business show is here to help you develop your business, stay afloat, meet all the challenges, and ensure that at the end of the day, you can still post some profits and survive moving forward. Let's talk how to make money. And for several people, starting a business is discovering the product, market location, and finding the money, and boom, you're good to go. But listen, the question is, do you ever pay attention to who is your market target? Who are you addressing the challenge for? In terms of product, who needs your product? And how much are you pricing your product compared to what is in the market? In this story, we speak to a business strategist, Alex Chienji, who decided to dump a job with a personal assistant to the president. Of course, he was a personal assistant to the president and is now venturing in producing porridge flour. He's adding value and is dealing in mushroom, roasted soya, and pumpkin seeds. Just take a look at this young gentleman's story and see how some young people are really changing the face of business in this country.
Strategist, 7 years of experience.
Okay.
We came up with the with this product, and we gave it a name: Unahi Mushroom Composite Porridge Flour.
Mm.
Why? We didn't just add value on mushrooms and pumpkin seeds and oats.
Yeah.
We looked at why. Do we need to add value? Because if we just added value, we would not have a market segment to target. You would just target everyone. So we needed that reason why the mushroom porridge.
That is very unique. You know what? Let's first build on from there. So you are saying you didn't want to be like others in the market.
Yeah.
Is there very some serious reason for being unique on the market?
Very. When it comes to the pricing, when it comes to the demand, when it comes to relevance. Mm.
So you chose not to just add value, but to go an extra niche so you can be unique on the market. So it's very important for starting businesses.
And not even on the market, to be relevant to the population. When we get this product out, we are 100% sure we are relevant to your body system.
Okay.
Not just taking in food on a daily basis, but we are being relevant to your body system.
A business strategist, so how did you end up here?
Why I ended up here? At the time, we Ugandans or Africans, we want to start a business venture because you started a business venture. You sell technophones here, I want to sell technophones nearby. So when it comes to competition, there is nothing you're adding onto your business than just getting what you're supposed to get.
Does that explain probably why some people start quick businesses and fail, saying I'm not getting anything in the market?
Very true. Because you have not put in the creativity, you have not asked yourself why this. I looked at so many businesses to start, and I had potential being those many businesses. But I said no. At this opportune time, I needed to look at the growing industry so that I grow with that industry. Not involving myself in an industry that is at the peak, because I'll add nothing to that industry. When you grow with a growing industry, you get a lot of experience. Then you grow. So by the time it reaches the peak, when people are now yearning to join that industry, you have benefited 100% out of it. Why the mushroom industry?
Exactly.
I am so lucky to be one of the experts in growing mushrooms. I have been in the mushroom industry for over 7 years. I was trained to grow mushrooms when I had left, when I was in senior five.
More like a family business?
Kind of? Not a family business.
You just
I picked interest. I paid, I think it was around 300,000.
In senior five?
Yes. Okay. To learn to grow mushrooms. I made research and I advise those who prove to be seniors in the mushroom industry. Some of them come here for advice. Why? I picked interest. I made research. Because I was creative enough, I became an expert in the industry.
You know what? Just tell the viewers, because you see, you picked interest and made research. How important are those two key aspects to someone thinking of a business?
When you don't make thorough research on what you are going to invest in, sometimes you spend 1 year, 2 years, and you feel you entered the wrong business. So you want to invest in the other business. Look at the time you've spent for those 2 years. It means they are wasted.
That's right.
And time wasted is never again. We have a very short period in this world. So you are going to another investment which you have seen some other person doing. So you also want to pick interest. I pray you don't waste another 2 years.
So they become four wasted years.
Four wasted years. Instead of making research on a given business, you put in all your efforts, the persistence in it, you make that business grow. At the end of the day, you reap.
What's your turning point around there? Because looks. So, several young people your age have ambitions, dreams, and just when they're about to take it, you know, they get such words of, you know, you won't make it. The other guys already selling porridge in the market. What do you think you're going to do that is unique, that you will win customers? What did you do around that point to get off that bed and start production?
When I got those phone calls, I called a friend of mine, he's a doctor in Japan. When I was making these mixtures, I consulted him. Because I'm not a doctor. I'm not a nutritionist. So I needed a general doctor who understands the body system. I told him, I'm giving up. He said, why? The market is not appreciative. The cost of production is high. So they want me to sell beer the cost of production. I need to have a profit on it. He told me when you first made the samples, you never tested on any Uganda. You sent the samples to Nairobi, to me. I tested through my patients. I gave patients who are diabetic. I gave patients who had pressure. I gave the malnourished. I gave the underweight. I gave the starting children. I gave people with HIV, I gave the old aged, I gave the patients. They responded on the porridge. If Ugandans are not appreciating, try your best, we shall export this porridge.
About understanding your market, because I feel like
At the time when you're saying Ugandans are not appreciative, is it because you had sold these things that are not appreciating in terms of we don't see the
benefits? Demand.
The demand.
The demand.
Had dropped.
The sales margin were not growing because they were not looking at the value. They were looking at the price. So the other friend of mine is telling me, look at the value. Insist on the value.
Not the price.
Not the price.
Pastor, not to necessarily drop to the common market price just to fit in, stick with what you think is worth what you're selling.
When we are in school, I just guess you also recall, there are people who we used to call commoners.
I know them.
So, if you don't understand your value,
yeah.
Someone will take advantage of you. Know your worth. I know my worth. I know the worth of that flower. So I sat down and said, okay, if Ugandans are not appreciative,
okay.
This guy has told me we shall export this flower. Now I'm making production for export. Export where, I don't know. Because I've got the courage.
Yes.
I said, those ones who will appreciate, they will take. Those ones who don't appreciate, it's up to them.
All right, so you know what? Let's then talk about the porridge, because now we know, you know, it's important to do research. It's important to know your market audience. It's important to know that pricing is not dependent on the forces in the market, but the product that you're selling.
Yeah.
Just don't lower your price because you want to be, you know, to get some customers. Tell us just how unique then this project is.
The uniqueness, one, is the mixture.
Which is?
We mix mushrooms.
The usual mushrooms.
They're the ones we grow, the oysters.
Okay.
Why we did the oyster mushrooms, and we didn't focus on the local mushrooms? Because there are people in Uganda who belong to a clan of those mushrooms. Actually, my mother is a clan of mushrooms.
So they don't eat them.
So the first person I consulted before is my grandmother. I went to the village. I start now, of the two, which one is a clan of your children? She said, this one is okay. This one we eat. But the local ones, they don't eat. I told her, you prove to me that you. She cooked them, she served them. I came back. Now, it is not about the mushrooms. It is not about the pumpkin seeds. It is not about the oats. It is not about the soil. It is about what do you need to have at the end of the day. We eat chicken fried.
Yeah.
We go and serve other things in restaurants, we feed the body. But have you ever asked yourself, how many nutrients do you need to have on a daily basis? Or you just serve matoke, rice, posho, beans, meat, everything?
I think it's more of the size, just serve what is enough.
Because it is there.
Yeah, it's there.
So we looked at which has what.
Yep.
Fine, we grow mushrooms. Mm-hmm.
So?
What do they have? The mushrooms has most of the minerals. The mushrooms has most of the vitamins. It has the saturated fat the body needs. It has low calories. A single item. It has less of zinc. It has less of potassium. It has less of folate. So the body needs the three in full capacity. So the pumpkin seeds come in.
I get it now.
Not just the pumpkin seeds. Now the pumpkin seeds come.
Okay.
Then the oats come in. So we would have three components in this flour. But when you combine the three, they do not taste.
Do they just sour, no taste at all?
The taste is just there.
Okay, so what then intrigues you?
So, the Nairobi people responded on the floor, but it was not tasty. So the other colleague of mine told me, they will not buy it because it is not tasty. Nature of Africans. But we want it to be pure organic. So I thought of soya. I called him, I've thought of soya, deeply roasted. Do kids need the roasted soya? He told me they need roasted soya, but they don't need the raw soya. So I got 1% of the entire solution. I added soya roasted. I sent back. They tested, they liked the porridge, it responded. So that's why we have the mushrooms, the pumpkin seeds, the oats, and the soya.
You know, I picked something off what you just said, and again, I will ask, what is the relevance of investing in a business before starting a business?
The relevance of investing, so that you do not waste time. You might create something like this, you put on market. At the end of the day, you have either to make some changes, either it has not peaked, either what. So invest and come up with the final product. Prove it, test it. It's a bit costly to get this packet and give it out for free.
That's right. But you want,
you want to
in
prove
the long
the
run. Yes.
You want to prove the worth. Is it worth?
So the thing here is business people should not always look at the short term.
If you look at the short term, the returns will be short term. Look at the short term, returns will be short term. Most porridge flours on market, they have flavors. They are flavored. Most, they are flavored.
But this is organic.
This is not flavored. People want the kawo, but the kawo and the aroma, they are different.
That's right. So, what is your production capacity right now, and how do you get the raw materials?
One, we are growing mushrooms on a large scale, but when the porridge peaked, I couldn't divide myself. So I put a small demonstration farm in Kagoma at my mother's place. Then I remained with training how to grow us. Those I can monitor, so that I pick mushrooms from you when they're well dried with a solar dryer, so that I don't find stones, dust. Because the nature of customers we have, most of them, they are corporate clients. And I was shocked that most of them buy their porridge flour for their children.
You don't say. So that's a market for you, I must say.
Why? Because they don't see value. The 4 years time, I penetrated, or I broke even in the very beginning of COVID-19.
You couldn't believe it.
COVID-19. Patients of COVID-19 consume the flour like crazy.
So, if you're watching, there are probably four basic things. We've talked about a lot, but there are like four things for you that is planning to start a business. We talked about packaging, understanding your market, the customers, research, and investing in the business before the business. Those are the critical things that you might really want to look into before jumping there and just starting to sell things, and 1 year down the road, you're often saying this business is not working. Alex has been here for 4 years, but he's starting to see the patience, resilience, and belief that along the way, he can meet his dreams. So this is part one of this interview with Alex. And in our second part of the interview, we'll be running you through the Kagoma plant, or where they're growing the mushrooms.
and so you can see what they are doing. And he just talked about setting up a factory and being able to, you know, train 200 households for the start, which in the long run will create about 200,000 jobs, you said?
200,000 jobs.
Yes. So if we can have that, then there are people that are changing this country. Thank you so much for watching.
I tell you what, some young people are really determined, and we can hope that the government watches such programs and try and inspire the young people by boosting their business. You discover that this gentleman's problem is lack of finances. He's targeting to train 200,000 families, and this will create jobs certainly. All right. How to make money this week. Time now for personal finance tips, and we're looking at how to help you master your money. That and more in this week.
On Personal Finance This Week, we look at tips to help you master your money. 1. Calculate your net worth. One of the most important personal finance tips to help you better start managing money is determining your net worth. Most 20-year-olds, for example, have a negative net worth, especially if they are just from college and are paying off student loans. Your net worth is basically a snapshot of how much you own versus how much you owe at a single moment in time. 2. Start a side hustle. There is a downside to saving money. The amount of money you can save is limited. In other words, everyone will have to spend some amount of money for basic living expenses like food, shelter, water, among others. 3. Invest in yourself. Investing in yourself is likely the most crucial personal finance tip, and yet it can also be one of the most fun financial tips. And finally, avoid lifestyle creep. Guys and girls, as you increase your earning potential, make sure you don't increase your lifestyle expenses, otherwise known as lifestyle creep.
Well, that surely should do for this week's edition of The Business Show. Thank you so much for making time. Now remember, you can be a part of the show by getting back to us on our social media pages. Drop us any comment about the program, and we'll be more than glad to respond. Viola will be here next week to take you through what's happening in the world of business. Of course, there's so much, from the budget to the oil sector to the reopening of the border. We can only wait to see what else evolves in the world of business. Until then, you take good care of yourselves. Keep making that money. Invest. And as a business person, if you don't make profits, sit down and think. We'll see you next week.